Hello everybody, I am Mr. Valase Keshav from Mechanical Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we will be discussing about EOQ, that is Economic Order Quantity, its derivation for a very simple model. At the end of this session, students are expected to understand what is the concept of economic order quantity as well as associated minimum inventory cost and the steps in the derivation of EOQ as well as inventory cost. This particular slide we have discussed in earlier video part 1. Here, this graph indicates on vertical axis inventory cost and on horizontal axis it indicates inventory quantity. This straight line represents holding cost or inventory carrying cost, whereas this curved line indicates setup cost or ordering cost. Summation of these two is represented by this U-shape line, that is total cost. This has been discussed in earlier video. Now here, I would like to think you all about the different types of costs we have discussed in previous video. Those we need here for the derivation. They are holding cost, setup cost, and shortage cost. I expect you all at this stage to think for a while and compare these different types of inventory costs. Coming to the derivation steps, this is a very simple model for EOQ derivation wherein the assumptions are mentioned here and these are some main terms we need to refer in the derivation. This Q is the quantity, whereas this T on horizontal axis indicates the time scale. So this in all a triangle indicates it represents one particular inventory cycle, and this slant line is R, that is consumption rate. Assumptions as mentioned here, just to revise again as against earlier video. This R, that is consumption rate, is assumed to be uniform. That is, if this quantity, if we take as suppose 300 for a cycle, and if this time period, if we take as 30 days for 1 month suppose, then this R consumption rate will be Q, that is 300 divided by T, that is 30, giving us R is equal to 10 units per day. This is what we assume this R to be uniform. Secondly, no shortages permitted. That is symbol, if we consider C2, we denote as shortage cost, and that will be zero. Lead time is zero or known exactly. This is discussed earlier, as well as instantaneous replenishment. That is, at the end of this cycle, we assume that for the next second cycle, we have quantity Q available. Next day we come for the business. So that is the assumption, that any point of time we need the quantity to be raised to its level small q, it is available. Now coming to the steps in the derivation, here we start with holding cost. In all, the cost, inventory related cost, is the sum of all the costs here. And to begin with, let us start with the holding cost. So this holding cost can be taken up as unit holding cost multiplied by average quantity multiplied by its cycle time into number of cycles in a year. Now symbolically, unit holding cost we represent with symbol C1, which is rupees per unit item per unit time. So this C1 is represented, unit cost is represented for one item and for unit time. So we multiply this by the quantity of a cycle, which here it comes out to be 1/2 Q, because this quantity from certain maximum Q level drops down to zero level. Hence, we assume that average quantity 1/2 Q is available all over the period of cycle, that is cycle time T. Hence, here we are considering quantity as 1/2 Q, that is average quantity. Now, this multiplied by the cycle time T, which is here, and like this, we have in all n cycles in 1 year. So this we again multiply by n, that is number of cycles in a year. If you simplify this, we get this holding cost is equal to 1/2 into small q into C1. Now here T into n becomes 1, because cycle time T is a reciprocal of number of cycles here. Now, secondly, the shortage cost, as we have assumed it to be zero, no shortage is permitted in the assumption, we have mentioned that, so shortage cost will be zero. Third element, setup cost. Basic setup cost, C3, is mentioned as a rupees per cycle. So to get the setup cost, we need to multiply unit setup cost by number of cycles. So we get it here, setup cost is equal to C3, which is per cycle, into n, number of cycles. Again, as said here, this n will be reciprocal of T, 1 upon T. Now these two equations, this equation for holding cost and secondly equation number 2 for setup cost, these two equations we will need for further derivation. So, from 1 and 2, from previous slide, total inventory cost will be holding cost plus setup cost. Here, shortage cost is 0. So, this C, if we take the symbol for total inventory cost, is equal to 1/2 Q into C1, which represents holding cost, plus C3 upon T, which represents setup cost. Now, here again, this T we can replace by Q upon R, and finally we get this as the total cost equation, which is the sum of holding cost as well as setup cost. I repeat, shortage cost C2 does not come here because we have assumed that to be zero. Now this cost equation we need to partially differentiate with respect to small q for this cost to be minimum. Hence, if we differentiate this C with respect to small q, we get q is equal to square root of 2 into C3 into R upon C1. So this q star we call as EOQ. After differentiation of this cost equation, whatever the quantity we get, that we have represented here as Q star, meaning that it is economic order quantity. And the formula for that we have got is square root of twice C3 into R divided by C1. Similarly, this Q star, if we put back in this equation, then we will get inventory cost, which will be minimum corresponding to this economic order quantity. Thus, substituting this Q star in this cost equation number 3, we get, and then simplifying of course, we get minimum inventory cost is equal to square root of twice into C1 into C3 into R. So this is how in all we have got two terms. If we again compile that in the graph, on total cost curve, as discussed earlier in previous video, This lowermost point is the point of our interest, wherein on horizontal axis it represents economic order quantity, and this is given by this formula EOQ is equal to Q star, which is equal to square root of twice C3 into R divided by C1. And for this lowermost point on the total cost curve on vertical axis, this point represents the minimum inventory cost, that is symbolically we indicate it as C minimum. So this C minimum mathematically we get hit here as C minimum is equal to square root of twice C1 into C3 into R. So this is how we have derived the equations for economic order quantity and minimum cost for a very simple model in inventory. Here as a reference, I just mentioned two books, but we have ample books in operations research in general and even for inventory control. Thank you.